Hello students, welcome to Knowledge Academy. Today in this important session of English literature, we shall discuss about meaning, definition and characteristics of drama, that what is drama. But first of all, I would like to say that please like, subscribe, share and motivate channel. And apart from this, you are most welcome for your suggestions and comments for teaching learning perspective. As I have told you that drama is a very important topic for English literature, this topic will be beneficial for making preparation of TGT PGT examinations, apart from this for university examinations also. Now let us know what is drama, what is the meaning and definition of drama. Drama is a long literary composition like the novel, but of course there are some basic differences between them. While the novel is a long narrative tale complete in itself, the drama develops through dialogues and actions amongst the characters on the stage and requires a large set of external paraphernalia for its presentation on the stage before the audience. So we can say, therefore, a drama is not complete in itself. A drama can be studied and fully enjoyed by the reader in his study in private. But we should not forget that drama is a public affair. It needs a number of external aids, such as we should not forget that there is a specific importance of theatre. A stage fully equipped with certain and light sound equipments, and above all, a disciplined audience with a certain degree of refinement. The success of a play depends upon all these factors. However, there is one type of drama which is meant to be studied in private and not to be acted. This is a closer drama or poetic drama. The poetic dramas were written largely by romantic poets like Wordsworth, Shelley, Byron, and before them all by Milton. If we talk about the structure of drama, in the context of structure of drama, we can say the plot structure of a drama is broadly divisible into some well-defined divisions. The drama begins with a background before the action begins. This part is called exposition. Then the action or plot develops by slow degrees. This is called growth, slowly, and growth. So we can say the growth reaches its highest point, which is called climax. After the climax, the plot declines, which is called resolution. Yes, of course, we should not forget that this is called resolution. The final stage of the resolution in a tragedy is called catastrophe. So tragedy is called a catastrophe, and in comedy it is called denouement. In this context, we can say some plays also have a prologue in the beginning and an epilogue at the end. So epilogue is the end of a drama. If we see the plot structure of a play, it can be graphically shown like this, that first of all we shall see exposition, then growth, then climax, then resolution, then end. There are two types of end. In comedy it is called catastrophe, and in, or I should say, that denouement.